Okay, back. This small plastic. It's thin enough with a hole inside. And we put it here to avoid any shorts that may happen between center post and negative post. In our case is the collector tank. We push it inside, and as you see, we have our center post. This center post serves, first of all, the more serious reason to contact with electronics or with a battery when Proteus works in a mechanical mode, and it allows the collector tank to sit flush with the electronics tube. The second is that it allows, the second of course is that we avoid the leakage, and the third is that the pole is moving, and it's moving totally automatically. You don't have to do anything to adjust the center post. Even if you have an atomizer that its center post is smaller than 4 millimeters, this center post can handle center posts of atomizers that sit on from 3.7 to 5 millimeters length. It is a very big distance between center poles, so in reality it can fit any atomizer with any center post you put on it. I was saying that the center post is moving. I will try to show you in video. I hope you will see it. You push it with an atomizer. Excuse me. You push it with an atomizer and it comes back. I think you can see it. Okay. So this moving application serves a lot of purposes. First of all, we have a great conductivity. It allows this piece to sit flush with this piece. It avoids leakage, and it gives us the ability of a moving pin. Now, why this collector tank is made like this? This collector tank is in reality a GGTS or just a G collector tank. I just reduce its length. It's not a collector tank anymore. You see that the length is very small. I kept the neck of the collector tank as it was, and I put the well-known GG ring to adjust air, but now the ring has no threads and it doesn't move up and down, but it moves left and right. That way we have no gaps between Proteus and atomizers. It is exactly made like the ring of Just GG, but with a different movement. It has two rings inside. The tolerance to achieve a serious result on air, the tolerance between the ring and diameter of internal diameter of the ring and external diameter of this, let's call it collector tank, is very small. It is at 0.05, otherwise air can't be sealed. And the tolerance between the length of the neck and the ring is again 0. No, excuse me, it is 0.2 millimeters. That way, when we put an atomizer on it, atomizer doesn't touch first the ring, because if it was like this, we wouldn't be able to turn the ring. Now, that way, we can turn the ring very easy. So what you see here is a small GG, just GG collector tank with a different movement of the ring. You can have, like I showed you on the cup of the vent cap of Roteus, you can have a solid contaction with electronics, something that I don't really want you to do it, because you may push electronics a lot more than it's appropriate, so you may damage it. But anyway, this ability exists for experienced users and for users that they know what they are doing. A very small cap, this length from here to here, is only 7.5 millimeters. Threads are 3.5 millimeters, 3.4, and the spring-loaded application that doesn't have a length because it can be pushed and come flush to the cup, to the threads of the cup, like this. Very small, very effective, with great conductivity and with no gaps, spring loaded application. And I say again, a very, very small construction. You saw how user friendly it is. I will show you again to see what we made on Proteus. Spring loaded application, very important. You don't see any springs anywhere. Push the plastic here. I forgot to tell you that if you don't push, if you break your plastic, if your plastic is burned, there's no reason of anything of this to happen. I just say it in case you may lose the plastic for any reason. You can take an O-ring. This O-ring is 10-1. You push it inside. And you put your center post inside, and you are ready again. Before I show you the electronics, I will show you Proteus in a mechanical mode. We put this cap, we took off electronics. If you remember, electronics were like this here. Let's put it all together first, and I will show you what you can do to make Proteus in mechanical mode. First, take off connector, then take off the electronics, And what we have to do is to put the connector where the electronics were threaded and to change this cap and put button. This is Proteus in mechanical mode. Let's talk a little more about the mechanical mode. What we need on a mechanical cigarette? We need, first of all, conductivity. Excuse me 1 minute.